All right, what is up, guys? Welcome to another video on prime logic. Today I've got a really interesting and exciting problem for you. So if you want to solve this problem, please pause the video because I'm going to solve this problem right now. So we have a big red, kind of red right angle triangle here. We have on the base of this triangle, we have a semicircle with a diameter of 10 or the base of this triangle. And we have another smaller circle here with the radius of 1, which is inscribed inside this area with these two sides of the triangle, and it is also tangent to the semicircle. Our mission, our job is to calculate the area, this blue area of this right angle triangle. So we know that the area of the triangle is so height times base over 2, right? So this is the area for all triangles. We have the base here, so that's 10 units. So if we can find somehow the length of this side, which is the height of this right angle triangle, then that's easy and the problem is solved. So let's divide this whole height into two segments. So from the top vertex here to the point of tangency of the semicircle, let's denote it as A. And then let's denote this part from point of tangency to this vertex is B. So let's find at first, let's find and let's work on B. So if you draw a line from the center of this smaller circle to the base of this triangle, so we have another, we will form another right angle triangle with the center of this bigger semicircle and the center of this smaller circle. So we know that the length of the radius is 5 because the diameter is 10, the radius is 5, and then we have another radius here, which is 1. So this whole radius of this new triangle is 5 plus 1, which is 6. And we know that the base is the radius minus this radius. So the radius of the big semicircle, the bigger circle, minus the radius of this smaller circle, because these two lines are parallel, they are perpendicular to the base. So we can subtract the radius here, and then we have the length of this, the base of this smaller right angle triangle is 4. So then I think B is solved now. Then using the Pythagorean theorem, we can easily solve for B. So we know that based on the Pythagorean theorem, we know that 5 plus 1 of this new triangle, so 6 squared equals 4 squared plus b squared, right? This is the Pythagorean theorem. So based on this formula, we know that we can say that b equals square root of 6 squared, which is 36, minus 4 squared, which is 16. So this thing is 20. So we can say that this is square root of 20. In other words, so 20 is 4 times 5. We can write that b equals 2 square root of 5. So we found b just based on trigonometry and Pythagorean theorem. So this is our b here. And what about a? Now let's work on a. So let me just erase the whiteboard here. So b is 2 square root of 5. So b equals 2 square root of 5. So now let's work on A, which I think is interesting. So we know that the radius of this small circle is 1, and radius is perpendicular to this point of tangency. Let's draw another radius here, which is also perpendicular to this height of this bigger triangle. And then let's draw another line from the center of the circle to the vertex of this triangle. So we have two right-angled triangles, right? Because the radii are perpendicular to the tangent lines. So these two, we have two triangles, right? So maybe the shape is not 100% accurate, but we have two right-angled triangles. So we know that the length of the tangents are the same. This one is A, and also, and so is this one. And so this angle is the same, radius is the same, the side is the same. So these two triangles are congruent. It means they are the same triangles. They are the same thing. So no difference and this triangle. So let's name this angle, one of these angles as x. So one of these angles is x, and this angle must also be x. So let's work on the tangent of x. So what is the tangent of x? And a right angle triangle, the tangent of x is the side opposite to the side adjacent. So we know that tangent of x equals the side opposite, which is the radius of the circle, 1, over the side adjacent. That's the one we are trying to solve for. So tangent of x equals 1 over a. But what about tangent of the whole thing, the whole formula here, the whole angle here? So this is a double angle. So we knew that in this bigger right angle triangle, the tangent of kind of 2x, right? This is the whole angle. Tangent of 2x equals the side opposite, right? The opposite side is the whole diameter here, which is 10 over, so the side here, so which is a plus b, but we just have a, so we just have b, sorry, a plus 2 square root of 5, right? B, we found b from this part. So one more time, the side opposite, which is 10, tangent of this whole angle here, over the side, adjacent side, so which is a plus b, a plus 2 square root of 5. And one more thing, one more interesting relationship, trigonometric relationship is the tangent. We have another formula, the tangent of 2x. So we have the formula for double angle tangent equals, so 2 times 2 tangent of x over 1 minus tangent squared of x. Interesting, right? So tangent of 2x, double angle, is 2 times 2 tangent of x over 1 minus tangent squared of x. So now we have, we can make an equation here. So we have the tangent of 2x from our first relationship, and then another one, then we can substitute for tangent of x, which we found for 1 over a. So let's substitute all of them in this part now. So tangent of 2x, so let's write it down as, so 10 over a plus 2 square root of 5 equals, so let's substitute for 1 over a. 2 times tangent of x. The tangent of x is 1 over a. 2 times that, that's going to be 2 over a. And then over, so 1 minus tangent squared of x. So tangent squared of x is 1 over a squared. In other words, 1 over a squared, right? So then we have just an equation. It looks a little, you know, not clean, not neat, but we can definitely solve for a. So let's solve for a. So let's kind of simplify this fraction at first. So 10 over a plus 2 square root of 5 equals, okay. So this fraction, let's simplify this fraction using a common denominator. So a is, it's going to be kind of the just the denominator. So that's going to be a squared over a squared minus 1, right? So then let's simplify that further. So that's 2 a squared and then over a times a squared minus 1. So then we can simplify it, 1a, we can cancel it out from the numerator and the denominator here. So that's going to be 10 over a plus 2 square root of 5 equals 2a over a squared minus 1. So now let's simplify that further. So based on this side, 10 times a squared minus 1 equals 2a times a plus 2 square root of 5. So let's simplify that. Let's expand this part. So 10a squared minus 20, sorry, minus 10. So pay attention with the mistake. So 10a squared, let me just double check it. Yes. So 10a squared minus 10. Yeah, I think so. One more time. So 10a squared minus 10, that's right, equals, so 2a squared, let's expand this bracket as well, 2 is 2a squared plus 4 square root of 5 times a, right? So let's kind of simplify that further. So 10a squared minus 2a squared, so these two, so 8a squared minus 4, let's bring it to the other side, minus 4 square root of 5 times a minus 10 equals 0. So let's divide all the sides by 2. So, okay, 4a squared minus 2 square root of 5a minus 5 equals 0. So that's the quadratic. Let me erase the whiteboard. Just a moment, please. Okay, so let's now solve for this quadratic equation now. So a squared plus bx plus c equals 0. So let's find out the delta at first, or the determinant here. So b squared minus, sorry, over, sorry, b squared minus 4ac. So b squared is this term squared, so that's going to be 4 times 5 equals 20 minus 4, a is another 4, and c is minus 5. So this is going to be 16 and 80 and 2 minuses, that's going to be 100. So delta is 100, and the roots, or the x, let's say, is going to be, so a equals plus and so minus b plus minus square root of delta, or the determinant here, over 2a. So minus b, it's going to be 2 square root of 5. So plus and minus this square root of delta. So we knew that delta is just 100. So square root of delta is 10. So we can't accept a negative value, because 2 square root of 5 minus 10, it's going to be a negative value. So we are in the geometry zone and phase. So we know that the length cannot be a negative integer value. So we can't accept this one. The only, so because this is illogical, right? This is irrelevant. So we can just accept the positive value here over 2a, and a is 4, so it's going to be 8. So let's find it now here. Maybe we can also divide, maybe we can factor a 2 out here, so that's going to be a square root of 5. So that's going to be square root of 5 plus 5 over 2 times 4. So then we can cancel it out. We know that a, so we finally found a, is square root of 5 plus 5 over 4. So we have a and b here, and then finally we can find the area of this triangle. So 5 square root of 5 over 4. So the area of the triangle is height times base over 2. So the area, the big area of the triangle equals, so base is 10 and the height is a plus b, or 2 square root of 5 plus square root of 5 over 4. So this is going to be 5, so the whole thing. And then let's find a common denominator here. So 5 times, it's going to be 8 square root of 5 over 4 plus 5 plus square root of 5. So it's going to be 5 times 5. So 5 plus square root of 8 is square root of 5. Square root of 5 is going to be 9. Square root of 5 over 4. In other words, it's going to be 25 plus 45 square root of 5 over 4. And this is our final answer. The approximate value is 31.4 something. So this is the final answer. And that's going to wrap it up for today, guys. So I really want you, I hope at first, I hope you enjoyed this video. I think that was an interesting one, kind of work on the trigonometry functions and just Pythagorean theorem. So I want you to drop your thoughts and answers in the comments below. It's really helpful for me because it is also mind-opening for me. It is really insightful for me because definitely I don't know all the answers. I also learn from you, and this is super, super valuable, really invaluable for me. So the one approach was this. I really want you, and I want to ask you to put your thoughts and answers in the comments below, or maybe if you have any questions or other geometry problems. And I want you to subscribe, share, and comment and like if you haven't already, because this gives me a lot of energy and motivation and inspiration to move forward if you haven't already. And as always, I love you guys. I appreciate you guys, and see you on our next video on prime logic. So prime logic signing out.